Inquiring minds also want to know about the vacuum signal plumbing, apparently. This is a Porsche 911 engine with ITBs and standalone Mtron EFI. Each cylinder has its own butterfly. It's right there. It's pretty high up in the throttle body. These are Kinzlers. So the center of the shaft is right about there, and the fuel injectors are closer to the actual port of the head. Anything below the throttle butterfly is considered manifold vacuum. This is the fuel rail on this side for the injectors. And then this side has another rail, which is just for the vacuum signal. So there's a port below the butterfly there on all three butterflies. And they're all combined into that plenum right there. This car does not have a boosted brake system, vacuum boosted brake system, because it's a long hood. This engine requires vacuum plumbing for three things: the idle control valve, the MAP sensor, and it also needs it for the fuel pressure regulator. This bank has the same air rail on the throttle bodies as 1, 2, 3. So there's a pipe in the back, which is brass. It connects the left and right bank together and has a T junction here in the center. At the end of this T junction is essentially an average of all the different vacuum signals from each of the different cylinders. The plumbing continues right after this T junction, right into the idle control valve. Now, this engine doesn't have the air cleaners finished yet. This idle control valve will get mounted upside down in this region. But this is the idle control valve, and air gets sucked in right here. That's what controls the idle speed when the engine's cold. There's another T junction before the idle control valve. That's this one right here. This is a brass tube that is an adapter that basically takes the vacuum signal over to this side of the engine. That's where the MAP sensor is, and that's also where the fuel pressure regulator is. There's no actual airflow or movement of air that goes to the fuel pressure regulator or the MAP sensor. Those are just pressure signals. However, the idle air control valve does create a flow, and that's why the plumbing is as large as it is, because when the engine's cold, it needs extra air. It needs a lot of extra fuel, but it just needs a little bit of extra air. There's no difference whether the idle control valve is open or you crack the throttle open with your foot. You're still putting the same amount of air into the engine, and the more air you put in, the less vacuum it can make. So the signal is still valid because that's what the cylinder sees. It either gets the air from the idle control valve or it gets the air from the throttle bodies.